You were, of course, someone probably that would be described as an ANC life member, or someone that was probably born within the ANC.
Of course.
What is it, for example, that you think South Africans this time around should really vote and support the ANC, given the manner in which it has handled or mishandled the economy, given the manner in which it has been associated with corruption, something obviously that, would never be associated with the Madiba himself?
Yes. Given all these reasons that you have given now, it is very difficult for me to try and convince anyone to vote ANC. But I know that there are friends and colleagues, people within our, social community who are purely just allegiance to the ANC. You know, the one thing that we know is that we believe that it's only the ANC that can ultimately be the one to deliver the change that we seek. ANC is the only party that has the machinery to be able to affect the change that we seek. Unfortunately, it has been marred by massive and a long term of corruption allegations and all kinds of negative influences and corruption, you name it. But, the only way I can appeal, like I said, to the people is that when you look at our history and where we come from, you know which party is serious about bringing the power back to the people. Now, we must also be patient and understand that it's not going to happen overnight. We cannot be a Zimbabwe and decide to grab land, right, from our predecessors.
You're talking about the elephant in the room.
We have to make sure that our people are in a position where they have the skills, they have the knowledge and the know-how to be able to turn that farm and make sure it continues to be productive. Now, if you just grab the land, same thing is going to happen in Zimbabwe. So we need a comprehensive 7 to 10 year plan, right? Where the staff, as each year progresses, they get more of the ownership of the farm, but they're also learning the skills and the knowledge to be able to take that harvest, process the food, go to the market, not just in South Africa, but globally, right? And at the same time, as the farm owner's percentage is, dwindling, right, he has enough time to look for alternative means to earn a revenue stream, right? So we have to make sure that all the interests of the different parties are looked after. Land appropriation without compensation is one point that I agree with Julius Malema.
That is one point you agree with Julius Malema?
Yes.
Now, you know, of course, that that is the country's policy because
exactly.
It was supported by the ANC.
Exactly.
And the EFF. Isn't that taking you very close to what happened in Zimbabwe?
No, I don't think so. What you must understand is that we are engaging, we are now saying, this is the policy that we're going to follow, but how do we implement it is the difference with Zimbabwe. It's the implementation. Hence, we have gathered the churches, because churches, if you think about it, have a lot of land, civil society, corporates, government, the public, to engage to see what is the most equitable way to transfer the land. I, for one, believe we have to do it over a 7 to 10 year plan. That's my personal view. But, of course, my brother here may have other ideas, and I think it's important to listen to every idea that is out there, right? Obviously, that has value. And then we may have to mix and match the different ideas of how we implement it. Or sometimes we say, hey, there's a clear winner here, and this is the way we're going to go.